we want this money to be increased from 25,000 to at least 50,000 as a minimum.
The leader of elder persons now wants the government to increase this money from 25,000 shillings, which they're now receiving, to at least 100,000 shillings per month in order for them to meet today's demands.
This money is so little that we cannot match with the economy of this country today, because one is getting a lot of money, especially when we are shopping. We shop from the same shop.
The 25,000 shillings they are getting is very little. And they are hoping, it's a very big challenge. We 25,000, if you put on transport to come and collect the money from where they are, it is being paid, it is very little money.
Joram Tibasima, the Western Region Member of Parliament representing the elderly, and Peggy Jowako, the National Woman Member of Parliament for the elderly, have revealed that they have drafted a motion that they want to present to the floor of Parliament.
It is very little money. So as a Member of Parliament, I have a motion on the order paper of Parliament to raise the issue so that these people can, their pay can be raised from 25,000 to 50,000 shillings.
We want this money to be increased from 25,000 to at least 50,000 as a minimum. So when we shall be given a chance to present our motion in the Parliament, we shall present it every day, and we expect to get support from our colleagues.
Tibasima has revealed that some of their money is not given to them by the district's administrations.
The chief administrative officer, through the community development officer. Those community development officers who are responsible, they are the people who have been giving out like this 5%. The rest who are irresponsible, they do not give out this money.
By people who snatch them, I will not call them thieves, but people snatch the money before the money reaches the exact beneficiary. That has been a problem. And some of them also withhold information. They don't want to disseminate it because they want to benefit from the same.
The Minister of State for Public Service, Grace Mary Mugasa, says the government will address their concerns sooner or later, but has further advised them to embrace the parish development model program.
But we really wish them well, and we look forward to working together with them in PDM as we popularize parish development.
The State Minister for Works and Transport has advised them to utilize their land very well and look at growing perennial crops that yield a lot of money.
They need to get some projects which can be equivalent to their age. Most of them are in maize. You find someone has 2 acres, is growing maize. Maize cannot yield much. But when you go into crops like perennial crops like coffee, we have seen estimatively with the extensive agriculture workers we have, 1 acre of coffee can give you 12 million per year.
In 2010, the government started the SEG program that supports older persons above the age of 80 to enable them to meet some of their basic needs.
So we encourage them to get involved in such a crops. Rather than growing these risky crops like maize, beans, where you put a lot of money, at the end of the day you sell at a very cheap price.
It was initially meant to support elders from the age of 65 years, but it was later changed to 80 years because of the limited financial resources. Report by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.